Hello, my name's Jean Illingworth and I'm an author. I think I've always written, but as a child I remember more reading rather than writing. I'm terrible at spelling and I was always encouraged to read more to hopefully improve your spelling. In actual fact, I skim read. I want to know what happens. I want to get to the hub of the story to move on and find out what happens. I never really took the words as individual letters in, so reading a lot didn't help my spelling. I'm one of a big family and used to go to the library with my sisters, and I'd get six books and they'd get six books, and over the week until the next Saturday visit to the library I would read not only my books but their books. And I think that was where my real love of reading and the adventures it took you on came from. As a teenager I probably wrote more poetry than anything else, had a few pieces published and really liked the intensity of writing poetry, the, you know, finding the perfect word, the sound of it, not just the meaning of it, was right within a line. And it wasn't until much later, I think, I started writing stories down rather than just telling them. When my son was small, I would make up stories, but I never wrote them down. I think I've probably got two unfinished novels from going back over the years. Probably almost finished. Maybe I ought to get them out and have a look at them and dust them down, see if I can do something about them. But it wasn't until later in life I really had the confidence to get my stories out there. And I think I really started with the very simple Danny Dragon stories, which I started writing in order to give Jamie, my lovely son, a platform for his wonderful illustrations. He hadn't been able to get any work as an illustrator, and so I wrote the first Danny Dragon story, and I didn't really know where I was going with it, but as soon as he drew Danny, as soon as he drew Susie, I knew exactly who they were. And we've carried on that like that since, that when we're talking about new characters, because in the children's stories I sit down and talk to him about them and he comes with plot twists and ideas, but as soon as I describe a character and he draws it, I know exactly who they are, and that makes it really easy to find their voice when I've got the picture of them in my head. So we wrote 8 Danny Dragon books, and 5 of those have now been published, which is wonderful. Another 3 still to come. The last one is the origin story, which is very different to the others, and I'm looking forward to when he gets to illustrate that one. But even though it's this mythical dragon and a little girl, they are sort of set in modern times. And this story is of kindness and friendship, because really I don't think the world has enough kindness in it. And it's just a nice thing to have. They're not really moral tales, even though they do have some, you know, little lessons to learn in them. They're just a bit of fun, I think, mainly. Beach Beings was our first full-length novel. And this came out of A Visit to the Beach, not surprisingly. And it was my husband's idea. I'd finished the last of the Danny Dragon books, and having written a year in the life of Danny and Susie and written the origin story, I didn't want to write anymore. As far as I was concerned, they were finished. And David, my dear husband, came up with the idea of writing about some tiny creatures who lived on the beach. I remember it very well. We were sat having an ice cream at the time and looking at the pebbles and said, well, how big are these creatures? And we decided they were about 6 inches high. And from then, it was very easy to write the stories, because as a child, I grew up at the seaside, and we've lived at the seaside since. And it's somewhere I'm happy. My talk about your happy place. The seaside is always my happy place. And I know it, and I know the beach life. I know, you know, what washes up on the beach and the creatures that live there. And I realised that writing about something you know is so much easier. You know, writing about dragons, I had to create a whole mythology that went behind them. You know, my Danny is vegetarian, you know, I'm sure other dragons aren't. But writing the Beach Beings first novel was started off as a short story, and then I'd had surgery on an ankle injury. And I was in bed with a pot on my leg and just nothing much to do, and picked this up and then wrote a second part to it 6 months later, probably. And then I shared it with my sister and she says, I don't think it's finished. So I then wrote the third part, and so it became from 3 separate short stories in effect, a novel in itself. And I loved it. I love the people. I love the atmosphere. I love the, you know, the stories of the beach. Even though these are imaginary creatures, I took great care to make sure that the life they lived, the elements, the creatures they came across, the way the beach behaves, the weather behaves at the sea, at the coast, was realistic. So your only thing you have to suspend your disbelief with is the fact that these little tiny creatures, the rest of it is as real as I can make it. And, you know, did a lot of research into the various animals and things they come across. Having written that, that was it. Once again, that was a finished story once I got all the three parts together, and I was very pleased with it. And then my friend Susan said, "What happened to Hanno?" And Hanno was just a character that came in very briefly towards the end of the book. And that got me thinking about what had happened to him. And so I started writing a sequel, not really meaning to. Now, I was fortunate that I had the opportunity just to write that from start to finish. And I already knew the characters and we introduced more, but I just kept writing. And I had the opportunity to write it all at one stretch, you know, over about 6 or 9 months. And I love beach beings too. I feel it flows better having written it all in one go rather than three separate pieces. And Jamie collaborated very much on both of those. When we had the opportunity to publish, then very much wanted to keep Jamie's involvement in them by doing illustrations for them. The Danny Dragon books were, you know, a picture per page and beautiful colour pictures that took weeks and weeks to do. So trying to persuade Jamie to draw simple line drawings just to go in a novel rather than a more of a picture book didn't really work. So all the pictures were done as painstakingly in full colour and then converted to black and white for the book. But that adds that lovely element. So you're not just reading the story, but you've got the pictures and you're seeing the same vision that inspired us as we wrote it. So that was finished just a couple of years ago now. I finished the second Beach Beings book, and that comes out in this year, 2021. I then had nothing to do in terms of writing, plenty to do otherwise. And winter before this one, we had some really bad weather. It was very cold and wet for a long time, very grey. And like most people, I hate it when, you know, there's no sunshine and the miserable weather drags on and on and on. And I started reading quite a lot about global warming, something that obviously, you know, everybody should have concerns about, and how in the UK, global warming is going to cause potentially worse weather, not better weather, and we're a lot more cold and wet days rather than warmer days. And I just started writing about that. And 2 degrees, 2 degrees being the, you know, once we reach 2 degrees in global warming, it's just really too late to turn back. The damage that's done to the ecosystem, to the environment, to the earth is too great. And so 2 degrees is a post-apocalyptic novel of a teenager living on the North Yorkshire moors. And having learned in writing Beach Beings how much I enjoyed writing about something I knew, even though I don't know anything about global warming, I know North Yorkshire moors, and I know this area where I live. And it was really, really good to write about something that I could go and walk and look at it and think about it. And I started the story in York, where I work, and took it from there. And it's a story about a young lady, a teenager, that's left alone, that's has to survive in a very different world than we have now, and the difficulties she gets through, and the inner strength that she has. And I think it's a very hopeful book at the end, quite a joyous book. Certainly the Beach Beings books and Danny Dragon books were intended to be joyous, to be uplifting. So even though 2 degrees is a much more serious subject, I think by the end, hopefully it's uplifting. And so I finished that during lockdown 2020. I went on after that to write a book on family history, which was just for my own family, and they all have copies, which I'm so pleased that I managed to record sort of 10 years of research into that document. So I then needed a new idea. I've now got into this compulsive writing. If I'm not writing, I don't know what I'm doing. And I tend to, when I'm driving to work, will be thinking about the next bit of the book. And when I get home, I'll write it down, whatever it is I'm writing. And then the next morning, while I'm having my morning cup of tea, I'll read it over and edit it a little bit. And then ideas will pop into my head during the day, and then the next night I'll write the next one. It might be a line, it might be a paragraph. If I've more time, it's a weekend, it might be a whole chapter. So at the end of this, at the end of 2020, I'd finished writing and editing Beach Beings 2 and 2 Degrees. We're both awaiting publication, which was great. And we'd just moved house, and where we live is in a North Yorkshire town, and just below us are some allotments. Now, I've always loved allotments. I never had one, but I just like the concept of people growing their own food and the community. So I started writing The Allotment, and during lockdown 2021, the story of The Allotment is coming along very, very nicely, about 50,000 words in. And this is an adult novel. I seem to have gone up in age groups with each book. 2 Degrees, it was more young adult. Danny Dragons for little ones, and then Beach Beings for sort of mid-grade, and then say teenager and now into an adult. And I'm absolutely loving writing it, because I could literally walk down the road and look at things and talk to people, and you know, bits of conversation and places appearing into the book. So hopefully lockdown will be over soon, but hopefully the story will be continue being written during the year, we'll get out there, because so far I think it's probably the best yet. Now, it's strange because I'm writing this on my own as an adult novel. Jamie's busy illustrating, they do the final illustrations for Beach Beings 2, and so he's not been as involved in this, but you know, I do read little bits and he usually laughs at me, but you know, there we go, as a start. So writing as a process, apart from the sort of thinking about it, I think anybody that has never written or doesn't think they can or doesn't think they should, just start. Whether it's on a computer or on a piece of paper, make a start. The books I've written, I haven't known where they were going. I've written an opening line, an opening paragraph, and it's gone from there. Interestingly, with The Allotment, I've already written the end. I've written the last few chapters. I'm about 10 chapters to get there yet, because you know, I started at the beginning and then wrote the ending, and now I'm writing the rest of the middle. And this is the first book I've known exactly where it's going. I know what the story arc is, and that's very unusual for me. The other stories, they're just sort of things developed, and you get to know who the people are, who the characters are, and you get to listen to their voice and know what they would say and what they would do and what they wouldn't do. And I think that's really important when you're writing, to understand your characters and to make sure that you are writing a character, that they're the rounded characters, that they are you know, drawn in words that you, if the reader knows who they are. I still write in the way I used to read, in that I want the story to move quickly. I don't want 3 pages descriptions of a sunset and the story not moving on, because that would frustrate me as a reader. You will get descriptions of a sunset and many other things, but they won't be 3 pages long. It's about, you know, it is very much about the story. So if you've never written before, just start. Think of something that interests you. Think of something you know about. Let your imagination fly. It don't have to be in reality. It can be a fantasy like Beach Beings or the Danny Dragon stories. It's just got to be something that inspires you, and just start and just see what happens. Good luck.